Swami Vivekananda was always connected with music, and he used to consider music as to be the highest form of art. And to them, who understand the music, is the highest worship. Music is not at all a thing to be entertained only. It is a byproduct of musical thing. Music is a path of spiritual realization. It's a very big term. But what you can understand who perform music or who understand music, that to just to enter the realm of music, you have to work much more harder than what you have worked from your childhood for education. It's a very hard thing. But anybody can listen to, that is the universality of it, that anybody can enjoy the music. Like food, anybody can enjoy food, but not everybody can prepare food. I'm beginning with one traditional Ganapati Bandana, which is very famous in South India, which is supposed to be the vocational music. So one Ganapati Bandana of South India. It is in Rag Yog, but it is called in South India Rag Suddhanata.
Yeah.
महागणपति मनसा स्मरामि 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 वशिष्ठ वामदेव दिवंदितम गणपति मनसा Kadi priyam mushakavagana Disciples a lot of times. This is a sort of a small song, and it is composed for doing arati to Shiva.
Shiva Yonkara, Japa Shiva Yonkara.
भज शिव ओंकार जप शिव ओंकार भज शिव ओंकार जप शिव ओंकार ओ हरि ओ
Oh, oh, oh.
This is a song composed by Swami Vivekananda. And it was tuned by also Swami Vivekananda. According to Sri Ramakrishna, Swamiji was an incarnation of Lord Shiva. We don't know what Lord Shiva is, but he is the embodiment of all auspiciousness. So he composed a song on Shiva, and he put this song to tune. Shivudhi song, this very famous song. And you know, he used to sing the Dhrupada, the old most, ancient most form of music, which was done for adoration of the Lord, to find the truth through the language of music. So he put this song to Dhrupada style. So we will try, because this is not the place to explore the Dhrupada in its full form, but little bit of Dhrupada Anga. Thank you. Rano Rino Rana Rino
Da 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 da
also used to request Swamiji to sing these songs.
प्रभु मैं गुलाम मैं غلام میں غلام تیرا پربھو ترے چرن لاگے ترے چرن
This is a famous song. We will finish with this song. This is in Bhairavi, very well known song.
Bye. Thank you. because we know music is the universal substratum to hold any amount of persons of any amount of cross section from the society, from any go of the life, they can enjoy music. And music, they who performs music for music's sake, there is no doubt they enjoy a lot themselves. They can forget the whole world, whole misery, everything they can forget. Others cannot do that. So it, also lifts them up a lot. And Swamiji has, we have seen throughout his life, he has sang songs. Sri Ramakrishna Dev has sang songs. This history of this incarnation is full of music. And surely this musical tradition, this musical ecstasy, this musical journey of this prophetic people again boosts us, directs us to take the music seriously. And as I told previously also, it is for us very easy to become or to go any academic line. Everybody goes in academic line in our country. Everybody tries, but it is not everybody's cup of tea to go for music, but everybody can appreciate. And this musical tradition set by Swami Vivekananda surely will encourage people to perform, to understand, to appreciate music, especially, very specially, the Indian classical music, which is so enormously rich, so hugely full of wealth that even a particle of it can flood any area of the world. And all the great musicians of the world, other part of the world, they take fragments of this classical music and they make big pieces of their own musical things. It is so, so enormously rich. As we kept the big, big jewels in our country, Kohinoor and all these things, and they stole it away. And they become famous with these small things. And we had all these things in our gunny bags. So Swamiji says, we keep our wealth in a gunny bag and they keep mud or clay pieces in a big casket. So we must be aware of this musical thing. It is directly connected to our emotions, directly connected to what we yesterday discussed, the spirituality of us. It is considered in India, an Indian, old Indian tradition of spirituality, one of the major 10 paths of realizing God. So, again, taking the same thought as given by Swamiji, I will request everybody who can sing to just continue singing. They can have a nice direction in their life. I don't think academic persuasion is such a big thing. Whole life can be devoted for that. It's not that thing. Even all the big, big academicians like Einstein, Satyen Bose and all, they all had musical background. And you just go and listen what they used to say. They owe a lot to their academic achievements. So, all who have this music inside, please do continue this music so that it will enrich you, it will enrich everybody, and it will enrich the tradition also. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. First, I would like to thank Swamiji for this wonderful performance and Mr. Premendu Ghosh as well. Swamiji has said enough about music, so I don't want to say anything about it. We all had a wonderful evening, and I think this is also a very unique occasion. Both in the history of IIT Kanpur as well as in the history of, certainly in the history of our Vivekananda Samiti, this kind of a performance, this kind of a, an occasion, and we, somebody, an invited guest who is like literally a polymath like Swamiji. So since we had very few people in the beginning of our session, we decided to put off the introduction till the end. So I would like to say a few words as introduction to Swamiji. Swami Kripakaranandaji is a polymath. He's literally served the Ramakrishna Mission in various capacities. He's an eminent doctor. So right now he serves as a doctor in one of the biggest hospitals in Calcutta, run by Ramakrishna Mission Seva Pratishthan. And he has served as a doctor in various other places where Ramakrishna Mission has hospitals, for instance in Vrindavan and Bombay. And and he's of course like a great singer. On a personal note, I grew up in the place where Swamiji lives, and in various points I remember in my childhood people actually pointing him out to me saying, can you be like him, because he's a doctor and he's a, you know, do you know other things about him and stuff. So that is all I can say about him. And a few words about our VS Vivekananda Samiti before we proceed to felicitate Swamiji with a small token. And Vivekananda Samiti is one of the oldest clubs under IIT Kanpur. And we have constantly had such sessions, spiritual talks and inspirational talks, as well as various spiritual retreats, meditation sessions, Sanskrit classes. We actually have a regular meditation session on Saturday mornings, Sanskrit classes, and including spiritual retreats to the Himalayas. Last year we had a retreat at Almora, where almost 7 or 8 students went with monastic members of the Ramakrishna Mission for almost 10 days, 15 days to various places in the hills. This year also they are going, and they have a more broad trip this time, not only to Almora but to Mayavati and Chamoli, right, to various other places. So I would request, this is a very old club, and in my short experience here I have noticed that we have had ups and downs in the Samiti, but somehow there's some force within the Samiti that keeps it going, and we have new things and wonderful things coming our way all the time. So I would request your active participation in the Samiti so that you can, you know, keep track of the Samiti's activities and join us for sessions like this. So right now I want to request Professor Mishra to come and felicitate Swamiji.
Before this felicitation, I would like to speak few words for my friend. He is Premendu Ghosh. Actually, we did not get any time to get acquainted with him, and he has been playing with me for a long time. He is a very celebrated tabla player. He had been playing with all who are from Bengal, they will come to know, since Hemant Mukhopadhyay, Manavendra Bose, Mukherjee, and then our Ramkumar Chattopadhyay, then lately with Lopamudra and all other celebrated. He is a very old and a very celebrated musician in this musical world is for a long time. But again, he has developed a tremendous, I should say, tremendous love for Swamiji. And because of that love, I called him that please come and assist me. He all the way left everything of him in Calcutta. He flew yesterday, today only. Today morning he left home. He came today, 2 o'clock, had lunch. And now he's playing, tomorrow early morning he will leave. So I would like to thank from myself and from all of you for Mr. Premendu Ghosh, for his wonderful devoted gesture for Swami Vivekananda.